It is what it is. Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you can hear a noise in the back, go like, it's my fan, like over there. So mind your business. But hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. As you can see by the title below, sis has COVID. That, let me even insult that, because right now she's in my system. But I literally only found out. Oh yeah, and that, my jaw is broken, so if it's throwing you off, just look the other way. But literally, it's what now? It's 8 o'clock. I literally found out around like 5. Yeah, but if you see me at 5 o'clock, I wasn't like this. I was a bit more pissed off and moody and just like, what the fuck, like why is it actually just happening to me? Like always me that all this bullshit crap happens to you and it's just pissing me off, and I was just in that shit mood. So I thought, as I was deep in my life, I was like, I'm actually gonna be sitting in this room for a whole fucking 10 days. 10 days deep it. In this box, as you can see, my room is not quite big. And I was like, do you know what? Even though I have a whole ass virus, I'm gonna find a way to make content for these people. I decided I'm just gonna kind of like vlog, not even vlog, because where the fuck am I actually going? But just kind of like record my whole experience, because I think, like, obviously now I'm fine. I literally just have a headache, but to be honest with me, I have a headache every single day. Like, I actually could dead ass have something and I wouldn't even know, because I generally feel ill every single day of my life. But yeah, I've literally been fine, and my God is greater. I'll keep being fine for the next 10 days. I literally just have to isolate and just be in my room like bread, doing what? I have uni assignments to do though, but that's not the point. It is what it is. I think people are gonna catch this thing eventually. I just feel really bad because I have a roommate. I live with Smisola, and I'm pretty sure if you see Simi, she's a bit dramatic. And I don't wanna get anyone here to be scared or all those kind of things. So I'm just like staying away from her. Unfortunately, we only have one bathroom. This is my get up to go to the bathroom. I have to, you know, put on your mask. Mask. Ole. No coughing, no sneezing, no contacts. My gloves. And my antibacterial, you see this one, is for kills colds and flu virus. So after I use the bathroom or whatever I touch in the bathroom, quick, just avoiding the window, because if I'm not careful, I'll fall out of this window, I'll jump. Just got into this new show called Rain, and I'm just loving it. This girl right now, she just entered public disgrace. You see this? This babe, Oti, yeah, she has entered one chance. One chance she has entered. Can you see how she's crying now?
Think I'm gonna order pizza.
No, Sandra, you need to save your money. Save your money. I know I'm gonna be doing this during this whole stupid self-isolation thing. I'm just gonna be spending bare pee for no reason. But no, save your money, save your money, save your money.
A few moments later.
Francis poisoned by jealousy and distrust.
Everybody just mind their business.
Pregnant with my husband's child, and if I understand.
Guys, this is how me and Simi this is how me and Simi have to communicate because of COVID
for 10 days,
guys. For 10 days deep. And Simi's just next door, she's literally just that wall over there. Simi's mom made her make us, like, you know the African stuff, the ginger and the garlic drink, and apparently it's nasty, and Simi just the utmost drama, because apparently this thing tastes like ass. Apparently it proper tastes like ass. So let's see. This girl knocked on my door and said good luck. This is what, oh my god, this looks like blood. I'm scared.
Bro, I'm too positive. Maybe because I held myself.
My juice smells like jello fries.
Yeah.
Why does it look like this? Why is it this color?
I think it's the onion, because it was red onions.
Oh, you put onions?
Bro, I put onions, I put garlic, I put ginger, and I put
blood of Jesus.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Okay.
3. Wait, 3, 2, 1.
Ah, blood of Jesus. It's not that bad. It's not horrible.
It's the aftertaste. It's the aftertaste.
I have to roll up my sleeve. This is serious.
Boy. Wow, you actually finished it. Wow, big ups to you, boy.
My mom didn't raise no pussy up. My mom didn't raise no pussy up.
Oh boy. Oh boy.
It's tough out here, G. I'm sweating. That team really had me on ropes, I swear to God. We like to drink with Simi, because Simi is our mate. And when we drink with Simi, she does it down the neck. Seven, six. Yes, Simi. Yes, Simi. Eh? Don't vomit here. No vomiting in this household. Hi guys, just wanted to check in. It's currently just about to turn 1 o'clock and I don't have much to say. In fact, I want to go back to my show. I'm about to start the show. Bridgerton, the pie is really good. Feeling okay. I kind of woke up today, like this side of my face, like all down here, have a headache and it's like affecting my eyes. That's me right now. I kind of had like a blocked nose like last night. I literally could not breathe, but I just stood up and I went to have like a really hot shower and that helped. And then like I did like this little steam thing where you get like boiling water, put it in a bowl, then I chopped up onions in it, and then I put, I'm Afrikaans now, boniki. It's like vapor for the people that don't know. It's like vapor rub, and I put that inside a bowl and put a towel over my head, and that kind of cleared up my blocked nose and stuff. And then obviously I had that stupid drink with the garlic, onions, ginger and lemon. I had that, drank that. Now I'm just in bed. My eyes kind of hurt, so I actually just want to sleep. Ew. That's not in my nose. I need to do exercise and stuff, but I actually don't have the energy. So my legs hurting, I don't know why. But hopefully I find some sort of energy later to do at least something, because I don't know, is this vlog just supposed to be me in bed talking shit? I don't know, we'll see. But I swear this is not in my nose. Guys, just allow me this one time. But yeah, that's me. 5, the day is basically over. I'm probably gonna go to bed soon. But yeah, I've been in this position all day. I've not done anything after since she's been here. I've been blowing my nose like a mad person. Like, I'm so surprised my nose is not bleeding. I ordered pepper soup for the African people or the Nigerians to try and get rid of this stuffy nose that didn't do nothing. And then I did that face steam thing that didn't get rid of this thing either. So I hate this shit. I hate this thing, a boniki, and I've literally been rubbing it on my nose and it's been spicing my life. But this blocked nose obviously does not want to go. I'm over this, I won't lie. But yeah, hopefully tomorrow, even if it's just for content, because I feel like this vlog is just gonna drag. Even if it's just for content, I'm gonna try and get up and attempt to do something. I'll try and do something tomorrow. So this isn't just a video of me looking like a whole man. I can't believe, do you know, I'm just thinking, I'm actually gonna post this on YouTube. I don't know if we've reached the level of comfortability that I'm gonna be coming on here looking very crazy. I also noticed like my legs are hurting, like, you know, like when you kind of like go to gym and you just have like body pains a bit, kind of have that, but like in my legs, not really anywhere else. But enough rambling, I'm going back to my show and then I'm going to bed. See you tomorrow. I'm a sister later. Peace out. Bye. No, I'm gonna do that again. Bye. Hi guys. It's even like the whole next day, like I literally did not even record anything today. Today I just wasn't into it. I really just wanted to just sleep the whole day. I just absolutely no mood to get up to do anything, even though I said I was gonna do something today. So this so this vlog is just so shit, but this is even quick because I don't want to do this either. But yeah, no changes, except now both my nostrils are blocked, so I have to be breathing through my mouth like a dog. That's me. Headache's still there. We'll try again tomorrow. Peace out. I'm gonna brush out my eyebrows because they're already not done because, you know, lockdown, but they actually look very scary. Hi guys, it's like what? This is probably the first time I've gotten out of bed in the past, what, 2 days? I think today is day 4? I feel okay. I just have to drag myself out of bed. I still kind of have like a headache. Man, blocked nose. Yesterday, couldn't breathe through my nostrils, was breathing like a dog. And yeah, I'm okay though, just a bit of a headache. And I feel like I just have a cold. Like, I feel like I just have a cold that's just a bit annoying. Today, I was looking in the mirror and I noticed that my mustache is coming back. You know what you have to do? We have to wax that shit out because I can't be out here looking like a man, you know what I'm saying? I actually feel like I was actually meant to be a man, but I accidentally grew a vagina and boobies. So yeah, and this is real life proof that I was actually meant to be a man because I have a mustache. I still don't know how to do this properly, don't judge me. Gonna get my micellar water and just clean my upper lip. You get your waxing strip. I'm so uncomfortable. I'm on my knees. But what you're gonna have to do is make this hot in your hands, I think. And then rub that motherfucker in, you know what I'm saying? Just go and go. I barely got anything off. Okay, let's try again. Oh, this one's gonna hurt, I can feel it. This is too much moving on. Definitely going to bed after this. I feel so tired now. 1, 2, 3. Ooh. Pretty hurts. Toxic. So let's just get rid of all the excess wax. Do that by. Can you see that? Fresh face. I hope that will do for a bit of content today because just doing that alone has made me really, really tired now, so. I don't even know what I thought would be so interesting about this. I have no idea. Is this just me in my room like bread? So, I don't know. I actually live in the ghetto, but yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing me wax my mustache. Till we meet again. Hi guys. Just quick update, shout out to my good sis Zemra. She bought me some medicine, some like stronger paracetamol, because I feel like paracetamol really doesn't work for me anymore. This one there, this one, the one you drop in your water, this one is hefty. Even see what that says there. Hold on, read what it says. Just see what that says. It says paracetamol with codeine extra. A few head of codeine, you know, that's some hefty stuff. But I took that, and it's probably not even been like half an hour since I've taken it, and it's kind of kicking in now. Like, my headache is going down a bit, my eyes still hurt, like I'm feeling a bit better. And she also helped me get, you know, these stupid nasal things that you stick in your nose and breathe it in. So do you hear that? I could breathe a bit through both my nostrils, so we thank God. My eyes really hurt, and having my light on is not helping. I'm really thinking, I'm actually gonna post these on YouTube, because I actually look very, very ill. Like, and my skin, let's not even talk about my skin. Spot, whatever the hell that is. But yeah, anyways, that's me done. Over and out. Peace out. Got this coat thing one day on AliExpress. I just saw it and I was like, oh, this is kind of cute. So, and I was just trying to, like, you know, style it or whatever. And this is what as you can tell, these trousers are a bit tight. It's not good to be fat. I don't own a crop top like this, so I just took one of my bodysuits and tucked it in. These trousers, it doesn't fit me, it gives me gap. But you see the vision, you know what I'm saying? I'm sweating. Blood of Jesus. You can see today I actually have energy. Yeah. It's not good to be fat. Before I go, I want to show you these jeans. And tell me these jeans is not cute. Check it out. Check how deflated. You see that? Check the flare. He's giving me body. Hi. Today I will be doing my hair. I'm not gonna style it today. I know yesterday I said I was gonna style it and stuff, but I'm not gonna style it today. Actually, I've changed my mind. What I'm gonna do today is just, I'm gonna, since I just washed my hair, I'm gonna put my hair in single twists, but I'm also gonna kind of like rejuvenate the hair, you know what I'm saying? Usually this like never happens, like ever in a million years. Usually when I take out my hair, I'm getting it done the same day. I hate dealing with my hair, but I'm feeling very experimental lately. And also my friend Zemma, her sister is like a I don't know what it is, chemical mixer or something. She shall mix stuff like this, and she didn't give me, I asked her to give it to me. She gave me one of these, like one of the like leave-in conditioners that she made. She said you could use it for like a washout, or if you wanna leave it in, you can do that. So I've been like dying to try this, and my friend uses it and she said it makes her hair really soft. So that's what you're finna do. And then I have some water, and then I have some oil to oil my scalp, oil my hair, sealing all that moisture, you know what I'm saying? I have nothing else to say to you guys. I feel fine. I've been feeling fine for the past few years now. Unfortunately my COVID has passed to Simi. I feel so bad for her. Honestly, I feel so bad, but she'll ride it out. Simi's a real G. She knows. Yeah, Simi's a real G. She'll ride it out. But I'm gonna just do my hair, and like if you guys wanna watch me do my hair, you can watch me, or you can just like skip, or you can exit the video if you want to. Don't do that, please. But yeah. But young boy got a stick like Moses with the Israelites, telling them always it's on time. They ain't out. My garlic bread is burnt. Don't watch that. Today is my last day of isolation, and the day I went into isolation, I was craving spaghetti bolognese. I'm missing cheese. You see what I did there? The meal I was craving on my first day of isolation, I made it today. I'm too good.
Many months later.
Guys, first of all, don't watch this frontal. Don't watch anything. You know, it's really been like 2 months. Next week is gonna be 2 months since I had COVID, and I'm only doing my actual now. God. I'm so lazy. Like, it's really been a whole 2 months. I'm just doing an outro anyway. I did an outro actually. I actually did an outro, but it was very, very ugly. Like, even though I look a hot mess throughout this whole vlog, that last outro was disgusting. So I said I was gonna redo an outro and then just kept postponing it, and now we're here 2 months later. But yeah guys, that was basically my quarantine, and that's how I was during COVID. Thank God. Like I said, there are people out here who are dying. At least you heard someone was in a coma for 3 weeks over COVID, and literally all I got and all my roommate got was a cough, and I just had a cold. Like, literally, honestly, I thank God, honestly. I mean, guess what? You see, this is new updates, yeah, new updates for you guys. So I actually learned a lot about this COVID thing, and honestly, it's honestly the most confusing thing I've ever experienced in my life. Basically, after my quarantine was over, you know, I've got friends I still see and I go to work. Obviously, I'm not trying to, you know, pass it on to anyone. So obviously I called 111 and I was like, oh, so now that my quarantine is over, how do I know, like, I don't have COVID anymore? Like, do I need to do another test? And these lot were just kind of like, no, just go back to your normal life. And I was like, but what if I still have it? They're just like, nah, go back to your normal life. And I was just like, what the fuck? No. So I did this test like 4 days after my quarantine was over. And then I went to work on Tuesday and I did another COVID test. And in my workplace, we get tested weekly, and we've got one of those rapid tests that you get your results in like minutes. So I did one of those on Tuesday, and then that was negative. And then when I left work, I got the result back for my Monday test, because the test I did on Monday is the one that you do in the house, and then it gets sent off, and then you get results 2 days later. And then I get my results back for Monday's one, and that's still positive. But I learned over this whole COVID thing that, you know, after you're done your 10 days, after 10 days of having COVID, it's no longer contagious anymore. So that's why they always tell you to isolate for 10 days, 14 days, because after that it's not contagious anymore, but you still might have the virus or the antigen or whatever the English is in your system. That's why if you go and do a test, you're gonna come out positive for a while. But yeah, it was very crazy. And then obviously, because I got that positive test from Monday, I sent it to my manager. My manager was like, I'm afraid, but you're gonna have to isolate for another 10 days. I isolated for 20 days. Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm sorry it took so long to get this out. A whole 2 months, you know. I'm so, so sorry. If I have not posted another video after this one next week, I give all of you permission to message me on Snapchat, message me on Instagram, message me anywhere, and give me serious verbal abuse. Guys, like I said, make sure to like this video, comment, subscribe, share, all of that, all of that, all of that, all of that. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!